coming here to celebrate their anniversary with me.
Anniversary? But they haven't been married for a year yet.
Well, you know how newlyweds are. They celebrate their anniversary every month.
Holly, wouldn't it be exciting to have a birthday every month? Let's see, that would make me 400 months old. No wonder I'm tired.
All right, get the lead out. Get back to work.
Is that any way to talk to a senior citizen?
Hey, Mel, you tell Carrie and her husband that they are invited to my housewarming party tomorrow night.
Well, thank you, Bill.
Hey, Bill, what should I bring?
Darling, just bring your own sweet self. And Ralph, thanks for rolling on my bed last night.
Hey.
Mel, get your mind out of the gutter. Ralph helped me set up my waterbed, and we had to roll on it to get the wrinkles out.
Why did you call on me to help you?
My bed is only guaranteed to hold up to half a ton. Guess who?
Mom!
You guessed. No, first try, too.
Hurry, you little thing.
Hurry, it's
okay. Hi, Mary.
Mom! You didn't do it.
Oh, I forgot. Hiya, chubby.
Wonderful to see you, Carrie.
Oh, you too, Alice. Hey, Mary, you look like a game announcer, too.
Well, it's not easy watching your weight when you're 400 months old.
Am I supposed to get that?
None of us do.
Who's the mom?
Oh, that's our new waitress, Belle Dupree. Belle, this is Mel's mother, Carrie.
Nice to meet you, Belle.
Oh, same here, Carrie. I've heard so much about you, and my little boys told me that you and I were going to hit it off.
Little voice.
Darling, I got a little voice that talks to me.
These two come from the same litter, huh?
How are you doing? You're looking great.
Oh, thank you, Alice. You too, honey.
Marriage must agree with you.
Oh, yeah.
Where's Robbie?
Robbie?
Uh-huh.
Well, me. Robbie and me, we're having problems. Robbie and me,
You really? Truly?
Yeah.
Mom, you waited so long. I thought maybe you finally found the right guy.
You know what they always say? There's no... Mel?
When she's depressed, she bakes.
She must have really been depressed when you were growing up.
Well, to keep your mind off of Robbie.
It's good for her.
Good for you, too. You're really raking it in today.
Oh, yeah. All right, Henry. Two coconut creams to go. $6.
Correct. I'll just take extra toothpicks.
Why?
The coconut gets stuck in Chloe's fangs. You make it?
What took you so long?
I was out getting all my goodies for tonight, my party favors. Listen, we're not usually busy this time of day anyhow.
Oh, really? Well, look around.
Mel, this is a first. People are actually eating and smiling at the same time.
The word is out about my mother's pies. This place has been jammed since you left.
What about my Boston creams to go?
Two Boston creams. Yummy in the tummy.
Come on, Belle, don't stand around. We're in the pie game. Hustle, hustle.
Yes, sir, boss.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, how is the dentist?
Oh, it was fine. I had my teeth cleaned, and I had an excellent checkup.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
But hey, Vera. We are busy. Carrie's pies have caught on.
Gee, I'm surprised that Carrie's still baking now that Robbie's called.
Robbie called?
Yeah, just before I went to the dinner.
Vera, Delirious. worse. She had too much Novocaine.
He called while we were out?
Will you lower your voice? I don't want my mother to hear this.
Carrie doesn't know he phoned.
What, are you crazy? If she talks to him, she'll straighten things out, and then she won't be depressed.
That's the idea.
No, if she's not depressed, she'll stop baking pies.
Shame. Oh. And if she stops baking pies, you'll stop making all that extra cash. Shame. Taking advantage of your mother, Mel Shuffles. It's the worst trick you ever played on her.
Next to being born.
Shame, shame. I'll drive in there. You tell your mother the truth.
Give up all this good money?
Mel!
No, I can't.
Yes, you can. You just put one fat tootsie in front of the other and move it along.
You can yell at me.
Oh, here's your big baby. Hi, girls.
Well, move it, chubby. There are a lot of pie crazy truckers out there just dying to sink their teeth into my peach tarts.
Carrie, Mel's got something to tell you.
Okay, lay it on me, Mel. The only time you call me Mommy Dearest is when you've done something rotten.
Mommy Dearest, while you were busy here baking in the kitchen, Robbie called.
Robbie, why didn't you tell me?
I know how you hate to be disturbed.